Hey, horsey people! Rick, I'm looking at the little horsey because he looks so cute with his little ears back and his bit and his spurs that were stabbing him and his cinch and his bouncing metal things and his cute little socks to keep his little feet safe because I love it. Look, I get so much BS about helmets and my anti-helmet stance and blah, 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 and the whiner and the feminazis out there. He's picking on women because we're scared and we wear helmets and he can't say that because he's a man. Shut up, you big dummies. Look, I don't care if you wear a helmet. I really don't. If you want to wear a helmet, wear one. If you think it makes you safe, then wear one. I don't care. Wear bubble wrap, a bulletproof vest, knee protecting, wrist guards. Wear everything and anything. I don't care. I'm just trying to educate the people who want to learn. And instead of putting their life in the hands of a stinking helmet, maybe they'll hear the real message that isn't being said because it's not popular. Now, I realize I cover a lot of issues that aren't popular, and I take a lot of heat from, and I got all these idiots making websites and videos and all kind of other crazy crap because they got no damn life, because they want to keep the ignorant going, because in a world of ignorance, ignorant people like that, okay? They don't want people thinking on their own. They don't want people making reasonable, rational decisions, because then they can't sell you their BS. I don't sell anything here. I don't get anything out of giving you this information other than maybe getting a horse a better life, and that in turns makes you safer, but you don't get it. You want to think the helmet makes you safe. So there's some studies here, and there's a study that absolutely supports what I'm saying, and there's been other studies that I've talked about, and I'm going to try and make a page on my website just about helmets with all these stinking studies and cross-reference and put all the PDFs and all the crazy where they push their agenda, and I'm going to show you some of this in here. But just looking at this picture, what do we see? Now, there's going to be the helmet lovers that'll say, "Ooh, good thing she has a helmet on, man. That probably saved." That ain't going to save her life. It ain't going to stop her neck from breaking. It didn't stop Superman from spending the rest of his life in a wheelchair because he was doing something stupid. He was doing something he didn't have to do. He was doing something that he thought was cool and wanted to win a ribbon, and he risked his life, and now he spends the rest of his life in a wheelchair. But Rick, he had a helmet on. That's my point, you big dummies who are arguing that helmets make you safe. What makes you safe is understanding a horse. What makes you safe is being able to call people out on their BS and not listen to idiots who put you in a dangerous situation and tell you you'll be all right because you have a helmet. You'll be all right because this horse is trained. You'll be all right because this horse was an Olympic horse ridden by an Olympic third jumper, hunter, jumper, 14 ribbon, river, gold medal Olympic rider. Therefore, just get on it with a helmet and you'll be safe. That's all BS, people. If the people who get me and understand and who want to think and don't just want to come here and play the poor woman victim, "Ooh, he's picking on women. My rice paper feelings got torn." Shut up. I don't ask you to come here. There's plenty of websites out there that you can go to and other videos that you can hear all your sweet, kind nothings about how smart you are and how perfect you are and how empowered you are and how safe a helmet makes you. There's thousands of websites out there and videos that'll tell you that. Why do you come here just to cry and complain? The people who come here should be wanting to learn. And most of my viewers do. And they're here because they're thinkers. I have a certain percentage of hate watchers that just like to come here because they got miserable lives. So they want to come here and be miserable and make other people miserable and try to start drama. But most people here get it. And I'm telling you, this picture is a perfect example of why I'm always talking about helmets do not make you safe. Stop living the lie and listening to the lie. So what do we have here? First, we have a jump, jumpers, obviously, pulling on a horse's head. I'm not a fan of jumpers. It's bad for the horse. It's bad for their legs. I know people are going to tell you it's not, but they wrap the legs. Old jumpers are in pain. I just did a video on the Eclipse, and it was a show horse that could barely walk. And somebody's going to go, well, it wasn't the sport. Yes, it was. You put a body and you put weight and you put pounding on hooves that are designed to carry a horse's weight. And then you add a human's weight and gear. And then you add a pain bit to where it's pulling on a horse's head. And then you get him off balance and you have him jumping high and landing on his front feet. It causes pain. It's not good for the horse. That's why horses fall. That's why horses trip. That's why they stop and throw riders. That's why 90% of the injuries that I see of people upside down with a helmet are jumpers. Either endurance or whatever, wherever else where they're jumping, cross country, whatever. When you start getting a horse jumping blind over things and landing on their 2 feet with your body, and if you're not perfectly balanced, if you don't know how to style the horse's weight, if you don't give the horse's head to counterbalance because you're scared and you're pulling and yanking on a bit, all of these things cause a horse to fall, trip, or balk and stop. And the result is the rider ends up like this. And she has a helmet on, and she's got her matching boots and her matching tight pants and her matching little saddle pad and her shiny bit and probably a whip in her hand right there. And all of that didn't change the result of this. None of that kept her safe. She even has a well-qualified trainer, hunter, jumper, Walmart certified, 100% fantastic trained Olympic horses, horse trainer, and that didn't prevent this. That's all I'm trying to say when I get you guys to think. I mean, my videos are about making you think for yourself. It's not pushing my agenda. I'm not selling anything. I don't get anything. If you go out there and do this, it does not affect me one bit. It affects the poor horse who doesn't have a voice, but it doesn't affect me. So all these things, the bit, the whip, the helmet, the spurs, the trainer, the fancy saddle, the perfect groomed arena with a nice pretty fence, didn't change the end result of this. So the reason I'm doing this is I want to show some of these studies and some of the comments on what people will tell you is great and good about a helmet, but what they leave out because they don't want you to figure out that helmets keep you safe is a lie. So let's look at some other things. Okay, so let's take a couple links to this article here. And I didn't take that other picture. That was on this article. When a rider falls, it says right here, when a rider falls, the head is usually the first thing to hit the ground. That's absolutely untrue. I've fallen off a minimum of 20 to 50 horses in my life, and my head is not the first thing that hits the ground because I know how to fall. I know how to roll. I've never had a helmet on out of those 50 falls. I've never had a head injury, and I've never had to go to the hospital. The only time I had to go to the hospital is when a horse was bucking and ran into me in a round pen and knocked me out because I was too stupid to get out of his way because he was bucking. And I didn't get out of his way. I thought I could move him or he was going to move. And at the last second, he turned into me, hit me in the head with his head, and knocked me out. And I had to go to the hospital. And if I had a helmet on, it wouldn't have mattered anything. Because when he hit me in the head, he hit me in the side of the jaw. So unless I had a full-face motorcycle helmet on, it wouldn't have helped me one bit. But I digress. So that they want to give you all these stats about, oh, a helmet will save you. A helmet. Because they push the helmet agenda, because that's the easiest thing to address. Because then all we got to do is tell people who don't think for themselves, if you just put a helmet on, you'll be safe, and you can ignore everything else. That's the problem. This girl needs to wear a helmet when she eats her salad, because she's afraid her horse will reach around a corner and hit her in the head. That's the safety Sally's going for you right there. So here's an article about helmet safety and legal liability. Legal liability. Okay? That means that if I tell you to put a helmet on, I can totally disregard everything else that I know is dangerous to you, and I can say, you know what? I told them they had a helmet. I made it a rule they had to have a helmet. They got on the horse. They did what they did. They're hurt. They're paralyzed. They're dead. It's their fault. It's not mine because my liability ended because I told you to wear a helmet. That's the big helmet lie. Another lie is riding a bicycle is less dangerous than riding a horse. I've crashed on many bikes. I've never worn a helmet on a bicycle. I don't even ride a helmet. I wear a helmet when I ride a motorcycle, except in California where they require it. And then we just went and bought some fake helmet that was plastic because it was nice and light. And we wore it. And people were like, okay, the cops knew it was a fake helmet. They didn't care. As long as you had something on your head, you were in compliance with the law as far as they were concerned. So in California, a lot of guys I rode with, we'd go out and buy these $5 plastic black helmets, call them just a little brain bucket, and we'd set it on the top of our head because they were cool, they were light, and they weren't the approved safety 14 inches thick with 4 inches of foam and passed by the DOT, Department of Transportation Safety Standard, you know, that they charge $75 or $150 for that helmet when I can buy a piece of plastic for $5 to comply with a stupid law that absolutely did not change anything. I've ridden motorcycles my entire life, and I've crashed maybe 2 or 3 motorcycles. Never had a helmet on, never had an injury. So it is what it is. But they want to tell you that because all this protection from a helmet on a bicycle, you should blindly and without thinking, think that, well, if it helps bicycles, it'll help me. A bicycle is not a living, breathing, 1,200-pound, independent thinking, instinct-driven, strong, reflex-oriented, survival animal that can move at the speed of light without thinking. There's a big difference between a bike and a horse. And I know a lot of the people aren't going to be able to figure that one out, but there is. Okay, so in this article, they give you these nice statements that scare you and fear you and make you think, ooh, I need a helmet. Ooh, a fall from 2 feet can cause permanent brain damage. Wow. So let me get this straight. If a fall from 2 feet can cause prominent damage, why aren't we wearing helmets walking around? Because our head is more than 2 feet off the ground when we're walking around. Why aren't we wearing helmets in the shower? Why aren't we wearing helmets when we're sitting at the dinner table? We're 2 feet off the ground. And if a fall from 2 feet can cause brain damage, if that's what we're concerned about, then we should be wearing helmets all the time. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And then, of course, they give you the alternate stats. A horse elevates to 8 feet above the ground. The human skull can be cracked or impacted 7 to 10 kilometers. And a horse is galloping 60. Oh, my God. It's so, and children's skulls, it's just so scary. Just wear a helmet and don't think. Forget about training. Forget about understanding a horse and their forget about control of the horse. Forget all that. Just wear a helmet, you big dummies, and you'll be safe. I hope people can pick up my sarcasm because somebody will be cutting that out saying, he's calling me a dummy and now I don't know what I'm going to do because I'm so fresh. Shut up. Jesus Christ, you idiots. Don't want to come here and cry. And then you make all my other good viewers listen to me complain about you. All right, so there's some more good information coming, so hang in there. So racing organizations require helmets and results in jockeys suffering less injuries. That's wrong. I'm going to show you a study that they proved. That's absolutely wrong. The U.S. Pony Club injured 29% with a mandatory helmet. Well, you know what? You're dealing with ponies and probably people leading them, and they're not riding very fast and not growing, riding full-size horses, and they're not making their horse jump 6 feet in the air and land blindly on their two front feet with a human pulling on a pain bit on their mouth with their head tied down with a metal bit in their mouth. Meanwhile, they're kicking them with spurs and hitting them with a whip. Maybe that's why in the pony club, it decreased 29%. Just a thought. I mean, use your head, people. Don't listen to how I'm saying it or the listen to the information. There is a saying that says, do not discount what is being said just because who is saying it. And I know the liberal left media wants you to automatically disregard anything that makes sense so they can say who said it and they must be wrong and you can't listen to that person because you just can't listen to them. Doesn't matter what they say, even if they're right. There's idiots out here in the horse world, these crying feminazis that come here and want to cry all the time, that if they were starving and dying of thirst in the desert and walked across me in the desert and said, where's water? and I said, "It's over here, you big dummy," they would go, "You called me a big dummy. I'm going to go the other way. I would rather die of thirst in the desert than listen to information that can save me." And that's what people do when I talk about these sensitive subjects about bits and pain and helmets and stupid things in the horse world, right? Locking up your horses to protect them from going blind during ECA. When I talk about these things, I'm constantly attacked and tried to be stifled and told to shut up and tried to use the YouTube police or other somebody else to make a complaint to stop free speech because ignorant people like it when everyone else is ignorant because they may be the least ignorant and they may be able to move ahead. So think for yourself. Everything I'm saying is trying to get you to think for yourself. Just analyze the information. Okay, so New York, of course, big liberal lift. We got to protect everybody. We got to tell you what size soft drink you can buy. We got to tax everything. If you want liberal ignorance, you go to New York. And they're going to have more laws for everything. They probably got laws on you can only kill 5 ants a day. And if you have 10, you need to get a permit and pay the government in order to kill more than 5 ants a day. Because that's how ignorant huge government policies are. And again, government only makes policies that appears that they care. They really don't care. But you can believe what you want. I'll try to leave politics out of this. But because it's New York, their information is horseback riding, popular activity, over 30 million people enjoy it. I think that number's more like 90, but there's permanently no safety standards, and New York wants to facilitate with the injuries resulting in horseback, so they're going to make a mandatory helmet policy. And they used these two. Some 23-year-old went out there in Buffalo, result of horseback riding accident. She was not wearing a helmet. If she wore a helmet, she could have been saved. You notice it doesn't say what this 23-year-old was doing. And by the way, Robin appears to be a girl's name. I know it's sexist. This article is sexist. Please contact New York Times for doing this or New York City because they're picking on this poor woman, Robin, because she died. Notice it just says horseback riding accident and it does not say what she was doing, how long she had a horse, was she using spurs or a pain bit, was her horse head tied down, was she jumping him blindly. It doesn't say any of that. All it says, she was not wearing a helmet. Ooh, because if you wear a helmet, you'll be safe. Because that's the agenda. Think, people, think for yourself. Then they quote actor Christopher Reeves was wearing a helmet. And he was jolted off his horse. And had he not been wearing a helmet, he would have died. But instead, because he wore a helmet, he's living in a wheelchair for the rest of his life, paralyzed. So notice here, they don't say Christopher Reeves, when he was jolted off his horse, they don't say he was participating in an extremely dangerous and unnatural state of jumping his horse blindly across jumps using a pain bit, spurs, whip, and he didn't have riding experience, and he shouldn't have been doing it, and the horse could have been tired, the horse could have been on drugs, the horse could have been in pain. All these factors, none of that is mentioned. All that is mentioned is the horse jolted him off. That's what I want you people to do when you read things that support. It's easy to find things, and most people do it. They want to find things that support their position. So they want to reiterate that if I find things that support my position, therefore I'm right, therefore I'm smart, therefore I don't have to admit that anything's my fault, because I can find other people that agree with me. Just because you find a bunch of idiots that agree with you doesn't mean that you're right. And just because something's popular doesn't mean it's right. There are a lot of things through history that were popular and they were wrong. And there's a lot of things that are not popular and it's the right thing to do. So think before you act. We got more articles here. Hang in there. So here we have a skier, and this study showed, this from New York Times also, they did the article, that there is a rise in head injuries on the slopes after they made a mandatory helmet law. Now think about that for a second, people. There is a rise in injuries after, 10 years after, they introduced a mandatory helmet law. Now why is that? It's the exact reason I've been telling people this whole time. When people put on a helmet, they do things they would not normally do without a helmet. They are finding that skiers ski more aggressively, do higher jumps, and take more risks because they have a helmet on. And that's exactly what I say in the horse world. People do stupid things when they get on a horse because they have a helmet on, what they would not do if they did not have a helmet on. Am I saying you should never wear a helmet? No. I'm saying that there's a false sense of security being pushed by all these studies and all these words trying to mold brains into not thinking rationally, but only to believe what they're told. And the message is what you're told, wear a helmet, you'll be safe. Horses are dangerous. You need a helmet to be safe. It's not your responsibility and it's not the horse. It's the helmet that will keep you safe. It's not your knowledge and training and experience that will keep you safe. It's the helmet. There's no mandatory training laws to make sure people are trained. There's no mandatory certificates for trainers of people that call themselves trainer and horse. There's no mandatory laws on when you sell a horse that is dangerous and hurt people because of poor training that you have to tell the person and then they put a helmet on, get on this horse and get hurt, and suddenly it's the helmet that saved them. There's no laws like that. There's only laws for the easy thing that lobbyists that support helmets and that sell helmets and that have millions of dollars invested in helmet sales who lobby Congress to make it law that people have to mandate buy their product and then they get rich. And then idiots who don't think, wow, everybody tells me that if I wear a helmet, I'll be safe. So therefore, I don't have to think. And I can do stupid things on a horse, and I can get on horses that I shouldn't probably get on, and I can use things like pain bits and tie downs and spurs and whips, and none of that will be the problem. The problem will be solved if I have a helmet on. It's just rubbish. So in this article, it says experts have ascribed that seemingly implausible correlation. It's implausible. Rick's been saying it for 10 years, but it's implausible correlation that the ability of a helmet to prevent serious injuries, like Schumacher, who was injured, the guy you saw skiing, I guess, I don't know if that's him or that's just some other photo, but because of the helmets and because of the equipment, skiers are now and snowboarders are engaged in risky behavior, skiing faster, jumping higher, and going out of bounds. And I was a skier for many, many years. I never wore a helmet. I crashed. I broke sunglasses. I cut my head. I made many bad falls. We went over the lines and out of bounds areas that they said were you shouldn't ski in because of avalanches. And that's where we wanted to go because we were risk takers. And we would ski down dangerous rocky areas. And I never wore a helmet when I skied. And usually when I got hurt is because I fell in a flat area doing something stupid. And there was a rock under the snow. And when I face planted, I hit the rock. So, and again, it was usually to my face that was damaged, not my head. But anyway, so replace this instead of skiers are engaged in risky behavior. Let's say horseback riders. Oh, no, we have to say equestrian because that just sounds so much more, I don't know, just horsey dignified. Freaking people in their equestrian. Can't even say a barn anymore. It has to be an equestrian stable. All right, anyway, so I digress. So let's replace skiers with equestrian riders are engaging in riskier behaviors, riding faster, running faster, jumping higher, and going out of bounds. It still applies. This study totally supports the position I've been trying to educate people on for years and getting attacked that I'm some sort of, I want people to die and not wear a helmet. But anyway, this spells it out exactly, and it's the same theory. Think, people, just because you put something over your head does not mean you stop using it. I'm always telling people in the comments, use your damn head for more than a helmet holder, because that's what most people that ride horses do use their head for. They use it as a helmet holder thinking they're safe, and they ignore all the other stuff that comes into being safe, like horse's ability, horse's experience, your experience, time with the horse, not causing pain to the horse, not putting the horse in an in-flight or a flight instinct response, not ambushing the horse, not covering the horse's eyes, not controlling his head so he can't see, not pulling on a bit when he's trying to use his head for counterbalance, not jumping a horse 40 times in an arena in one day to where he starts to show pain and fatigue. No athlete trains over and over for the same thing because they know it increases the chance of injury. You will not see any Olympic trainer jumping their high jump, trying their max jump 10 times a day for 10 days straight. They just don't do it. People do it with horses all the time because they think horses, because they don't complain, because they don't file a complaint, because they don't write a letter to somebody saying, hey, my rider's really riding me too hard, my legs are hurting, and my tendons are hurting, and my joints are sore, and I have an injury, and if I jump next time, I'm probably going to trip and fall because I'm in pain, and because I'm sore, and I'm not given the time to heal. Because a horse doesn't say that. You got idiots in a horse world training their horse every day, running around in circles, or they come out on a weekend and train them for 4 hours straight, and thinking when a horse trips and falls that the horse is being mean and not listening, and it needs to be shown who's boss. And in this document, it says the results of this study presented in emergency departments from 2004 to 2010. The estimate was calculated from 1629 cases registered. The number of head injuries increased from 9,300 in 2004 and 2005 to 14,947,000 in 2009 and 2010. Well, how can this be, Rick? We are told if they wore helmets, they would be safer. And we required them to wear helmets. And they were all wearing helmets, but injuries went up. Rick, this just can't be. My brain's going to explode because I've always been told a helmet keeps me safe. And in this article, in conclusion, skiing and snowboard-related head injuries increased from 2004 to 2015 higher rate than all other ski and skateboard-related injuries, despite a significant increase in helmet use. Now, in this article, it says most of the ski boarders were males. Ooh, this article's sexist. I wonder how many males are...
Hey, who's picking on males? Why are they picking on males? They shouldn't say all males. That's sexist.
I wonder how many males are going to come here crying like that. Let me give you a hint. Zero. Okay, and in this study on injuries... Oh, 80 patients, they're picking on women here. All you women police out there, get out here. Go to this article and tell them they're being sexist. All patients seen in the trauma, 54% were female. Average age, 37 years. Why are they picking on women? Why are they picking on older women? They get into some other stats here. Hang on. Okay, so they're talking about the mechanics of the injury here. 55% were kicked or stepped on. Let me give you a clue here. That's because the person didn't understand the horse, didn't read the signs of the horse, wasn't paying attention to the horse, or got in the horse's way. That's why 55% were kicked or stepped on. It wasn't the helmet that protected them. It was not using their head for more than a helmet holder that got them kicked or stepped on. 28% were thrown off or fell off. That wasn't the helmet. That was them not understanding their horse or doing something to where they lost their balance, working above their abilities, doing things they shouldn't have been done, but because they had a helmet, they thought they'd be all right. 21% falling off. Well, gee, that's a shocker. Nobody falls off a horse anymore. Well, Rick, but they have a helmet on, so they'll be okay. Okay, that's great. We've made falling off a horse safe. We even teach emergency dismount, jumping off horses that are running because we have helmets on and you'll be safe. I mean, it's just unbelievable that the ignorance that is passed on in the horse world and nobody wants to call it out because they're afraid that they'll be attacked by the woman police out there. You're picking on women! Why are you picking on women? Okay, let's see. The average length of 3 to 5 days, all patients were discharged for home with 95% requiring no services. So basically, they had a boo-boo. I forgot one big part here. The cause ranged from carelessness, lack of attention to animal factors, including inadequate training of horse and animal fear. This is the first article that has addressed the things that I keep saying people need to pay attention to instead of the damn helmet. Carelessness, lack of understanding of the horse, lack of attention to the animal, lack of understanding of the horse, including inadequate training, lack of understanding of the horse and your abilities to control the horse, and animal fear. Animal fear being the horse fear and the human fear. I know you're all thinking they're talking about the horse. I'm talking about the human. Because those are factors that get people hurt. and a helmet does not change any of those. As a matter of fact, a helmet causes the animal fear of the human to be less, and that causes them to get hurt. In my opinion, down here it says, but ultimately proper training and adequate safety precautions are the only viable solution. Safety precautions is not putting a helmet on your head. Safety precautions is using your head to think, is what I'm doing dangerous? Am I prepared? Am I confident my horse can do it and I can do it with relative safely without causing injury to me or my horse? It requires thinking. It requires critical thinking and evaluation. It doesn't require just strapping a stinking bucket to your head and saying, I'm safe because everybody tells me helmets keep me safe. Despite natural equestrian organizations' attempt to curb injuries, the uncertain nature of dealing with another living organism, i.e. the horse, continues to make equestrian, i.e. horse sports, more dangerous than automobile racing, motorcycle riding, and rugby. The reason why it's more dangerous is you have idiots doing it, wearing a helmet, thinking they're protected. That's the problem. Demographics, total age of patients were identified in this study. Now, this is just one hospital. Consisted slightly more women. Oh, man, they're sexist. This article is bad. Average 38 sevens, only the patient documented helmet use. Three additional patients were riding as horse jockeys, which means they were racing and running their horse. And no helmet was documented in use. Alcohol intake of the patients, hell, I don't know. You can read the article yourself. Now, in this article, in this study, they said that all these were horse-related activities and, you know, helmet use and all this other. Look at what the people were hurt out of the 80 injuries. 39 kicked by a horse. Kicked by a horse. You know what that tells me? You're a dummy. If you're getting kicked by a horse, you did something wrong. You weren't paying attention. You didn't read the signs. You approached the horse. You scared the horse. You got too comfortable. You thought the helmet would protect you, and you got kicked because you're a dummy. Rick, not everybody that gets kicked. Shut up. Thrown or fell from a horse, 22. Stepped on by a horse, 4. So there's dummies out there running around putting their feet under a horse's hoof, and they're blaming the horse and running the emergency room saying, ooh, you should have had a helmet on. That horse wouldn't have stepped on you. Are you kidding me? And then you have one that's not even involving a horse, and they've got it in a study about horse-related injuries. Then you have one that's other. I don't know what the hell that one is. So in closing, I hope you get out of this to think before you act, to not fall into a false belief that because I have a helmet on, I'm safe. Therefore, I have no responsibility for what I do to my horse or do to myself or what position I put my horse in or what I cause to happen. Remember, none of these injuries would have happened unless the person injured got around a horse. So the horse had no decision in none of these injuries. So people will be out there blaming the horse, saying it's the horse's fault. The horse should have done this. The horse. It's never the horse's fault. And not one of these injuries was a horse design. It was all people either approaching, getting stepped on, getting kicked, falling off, jumping, forcing a horse, riding a horse, putting a bit. It's all the human's fault, and everybody wants to blame the horse. They want to blame me because I'm picking on women. They don't want to look at the spurs, the bits, the whips. They want to say, wear a helmet and you'll be safe. Okay, I really hope this opens some people's minds and makes people start thinking about what they're doing with their horses and not feeling safe just because they have a helmet on. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy Miff T, you're good boys. I got to laugh one more time. All right, we'll end that there. Poor little horse. He's like, dude, I didn't do nothing. I just tried to stop. Man, you were pulling on me. Don't be mad at me. Never the horse's fault. All right, we'll end that there.